TUNAP tackles the challenge to enhance marine protected areas management through an innovative approach for governance based on the wetland contract. The wetland contract was already tested in the WetNet project funded by the Interreg Med program. Besides MedWet, 11 partners from 7 countries joined forces to make TUNAP a success story for biodiversity protection. The role of MedWet in TUNAP is transversal. We try to make partners collaborate to facilitate dialogue among institutions and most of all to try to reduce conflicts among conservation and economic use. MedWet is an intergovernmental organization bringing together 27 countries, a number of international environmental organizations, scientists, researchers, and the civil society. MedWet is most of all a network of 200 Ramsar site managers that are marine and coastal wetlands protected by the Ramsar Convention. As MedWet, our goal is most of all to achieve concrete conservation. For this reason, MedWet decided to join the TUNAP project to support countries to improve marine protected areas governance and achieve concrete biodiversity protection.
Marie Romani, I'm working for MedPAN, the Mediterranean Marine Protected Areas Network. Today we are between the Côte Bleue Marine Park and the Calanque National Park, close to the city of Marseille. These are two marine protected areas. Marine protected areas are effective tools to protect biodiversity and also to support socio-economic sustainable activities such as small-scale fishing and also ecotourism. Marine protected areas, to be effective, they need enough and sufficient material, human and also financial means. And they need also a shared management and shared governance approach with all the actors of the territories. Today in the Mediterranean, there are 7% of marine protected areas that cover the Mediterranean Sea. But behind this figure, there is a high diversity of designation of MPAs at local, national, European and international levels. And there is also a high disparity between the different means to manage effectively those MPAs. It's important to invest in marine protected areas, and it's important also to reinforce the dialogue between all the stakeholders, governmental and non-governmental, at all levels, local level, national and international level.
Fabrice Bernard, délégué européen international au Conservatoire du Littoral. We are here today on the site of Conservatoire du Littoral. This site is close to the second city of France, Marseille, and it's 3,000 hectares definitely protected by the Conservatoire du Littoral. We know that all the sites on the coast have to be protected for a long time, and here in the Conservatoire du Littoral, we are a public organization and we never manage our sites. We are only the owners. But for the management, we organize collaborative approach with NGOs, local communities, to be sure that all the partners of the local sites are involved and really take care of the site for a long term. The Barcelona Convention is an international agreement involving all the 21 countries around the Mediterranean basin and the European Union. All together, they try to organize the best way to protect and organize the management for the long term of the marine part and the coastal part of the Mediterranean Sea. Thanks to the Protocol of Integrated Coastal Zone Management, all the institutional actors of the Mediterranean countries work all together to protect the coast and the sea of the Mediterranean basins. But now, with the Mediterranean Consortium for Biodiversity, the stakeholders for concrete action on the field to protect biodiversity will join their force, their competencies, their networks, to work all together to protect all the different kinds of ecosystems of the seas.
name is Michael Carner, and we are in Niolon, France. I work for Plan Bleu, which is a regional activity center of the United Nations Environment Programme's Mediterranean Action Plan. We are based in Marseille, France, and are leading the Mediterranean Biodiversity Protection Community's efforts to capitalize on the results of its projects, including TUNOP. This means disseminating TUNOP's results to policymakers, communicating with key Mediterranean stakeholders, and engaging in community building and networking. A crucial aspect of TUNOP's work consists in the participatory and multidisciplinary approaches used in wetland and marine protected area contracts. It's all about building synergies. Participation is essential to success because in this region we are all in the same boat. This is crucial for the long-term protection of these valuable natural areas. If you are passionate about protecting Mediterranean biodiversity, sign up to our Mediterranean Biodiversity Protection Declaration today.
The Mediterranean Biodiversity Protection Community is a project that brings together TUNOP with other Interreg Mediterranean projects to try and foster a sustainable use of the Mediterranean resources. The Mediterranean Biodiversity Protection Community is led by ETC UMA in Malaga and is organizing a series of actions and workshops to try and bring together all these actors interested in biodiversity protection. In the case of TUNOP, what we can highlight is the participatory approaches they are taking towards biodiversity protection. What we do with them is try to bring together in a catalogue of tools regarding management, monitoring, and also geospatial tools that could be used by the different stakeholders to arrange a rational use of natural resources. In addition to this, we also organize meetings. We organize joint publications trying to bring together the best available science and knowledge, and we have a platform where we try to make all this information available. This Mediterranean Biodiversity Protection Knowledge platform is available at Mediterranean level, but also for local practices to check what's being done in each area. We hope that with the support of the community of active actors in the Mediterranean, we'll get together to the same objective, a better conserved Mediterranean.